Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Teays High School. Tonight's game between our guests, the thousands of Fairfield Union High School and Teays High teams. Teays High makes an invitation to all our fans to help demonstrate this person to their game. The schools are presented here are members of the Ohio High School Athletic Association and abide by the rules and regulations as set forth by the association to maintain high standard of conduct competition in relation with member schools. These are high school athletes participating tonight from their rivals. Please help us promote sportsmanship by talking to charity and positive things that happen during the game. Thank you for being here, and let's remember to respect the game. The official side of this game has been selected according to the procedures adopted by the Ohio High School Athletic Association. Their experience and integrity qualify them for their important part in the strength and interscholastic contest. The officials for tonight's game are Joe Kokoska, Myron Best, and Eric Benning. Ohio Health provides athletic training service. Our school tonight's trainer is Kaylee Sarabell. Ladies and gentlemen, to honor America, please stand for the playing of our national anthem performed by the Teays Valley Pep Band. Introducing the starting lineup for our guest, the Falcons. Number 2, Violet Senior, Corey Eggorn. Number 5, 6'4 Junior, Keegan Arnett. Number 11, 6'4 Senior, Caleb Redding. Number 46, 6 Senior, Caleb Schmelzer. And 33, 6'1 Junior, Max Stansberry. The Falcons are coached by Travis Schaefer, assisted by John Helfer, Trent Johnson, Seth Bieber, and Greg Booth. And now for the starting lineup, your Teays, Molly Spikey. Now Viking 3, Luke Bergen, his first team first. Viking 44, Sam Miller, his first team second. Down.
Thank you.
And again, the foul is 33, Max Stansbury. And the kick of Vikings 3, Luke Bergen.
Thank you.
That's the top of 20, Kayla Schneider. Down top of 30, Gary Max stands here, his first and second. In the game, the Falcons 11, Caleb Reddy. Top 11, Caleb Redding, who's 13, third. Home run, yes, sir, in line 22. Henry Gage, the top is 10, I say it along. Thank you. That's what's good for 5-20, Caleb Schmelzer. Down by 3, Luke Bergen, his second, team fifth. Caleb Schmelzer at the line. And a game for the Vikings, 23, Caden Burden.
Thank you. Thank you. At Benton County National Bank, our roots run deep and our branches are strong. What does that mean to you? It means that our family tree is rooted in 1867, making us one of the nation's oldest banks. It means that our family tree consists of branches across Ohio, and that we change with the seasons to offer the latest banking technology. We're experienced community bankers, excited to help with whatever you need. Visit VCN.
Business banking with the Savings Bank is now smarter and faster than ever. Introducing the Smart Business Suite of banking products, designed to help you spend more time on business and less time on banking. These include MyTSB Mobile for Business, Remote Deposit Capture, and Online Bill Pay. Begin your journey towards smarter business banking by stopping by any of our branches today. The Savings Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
County National Bank. Our roots run deep and our branches are strong. What does that mean to you? It means that our family tree is rooted in 1867, making us one of the nation's oldest banks. It means that our family tree consists of branches across Ohio. Change with the seasons to offer the latest banking technology. We're experienced community bankers, excited to help with whatever you need.
Business banking with the Savings Bank is now smarter and faster than ever. Introducing the Smart Business Suite of banking products, designed to help you spend more time on business and less time on banking. These include MyTSB Mobile for Business, Remote Deposit Capture, and Online Bill Pay. Begin your journey towards smarter business banking by stopping by any of our branches today. The Savings Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Find themselves in a 16-point deficit. Now they've got to go to offense. They've got to go to work early here on offense to get this lead cut down.
Redding finds Smelter out top. Smelter drives, pump fake. And nice strong move that time by Smelter as he's able to draw the foul.
Now Smelter starts to step up in this big moment, making his presence felt, chance for a three-point play here.
And that'll be the fourth on Kevin McDowell.
And Smelter knocks it down, makes it a three-point play. Now the lead is cut to 13 for the Vikings.
Sam Miller loses it, and another turnover for the Vikings. Smelter looks to push it, and a nice finish by DeLong.
Falcons showing some signs of life here late. We'll see how Teays Valley responds.
8 points for DeLong, so 4.5 minutes now left in the game. Sam Miller will pull things back out now as the Vikings look to slow it down. Kevin McDowell gets it to Brody Fields. Nungester will take a three and in and out as Smelter pulls down another rebound.
Good look there.
He gets it ahead to Arnett. Or Redding, rather. Just under 4 minutes now left in the game.
And now I see the Falcons looking for shots on the perimeter, something that they have not been doing often here in this game. I believe they should keep working in on the paint. That's been what's working.
DeLong can't get that one to go. Cole Nungester pulls down the rebound for the Vikings. 3.5 now left in the game. Brody Fields with a tough shot. Almost went. But he'll draw a foul nonetheless with 3:18 left in the game.
Fields continuing to make a difference here on offense, whether it's through scoring, drawing fouls, and now he has a chance to go to the line, make some more free throws. Remember, Fields is coming off of a 44 consecutive made free throw streak. That's good for tied for 15th all time in OHSA history.
Yeah, pretty remarkable streak, considering he's only a sophomore and is able to knock down that pair, and that gives him 18 now on the night. 3:17 left in the game.
something we failed to mention so far is that he's broken the school record for consecutive makes by a long shot.
We'll have to get our stats department on that one. Willie G in our stats department.
That's right.
Arnett out top now for Fairfield Union. Smelter with a spin move. Nice look inside. Redding able to finish that. 2:48. And good job by McDowell to knock it off the Fairfield Union defender. So Vikings with a 55-44 lead. 2:43 now left in the game. Cole Nungester now out top for the Vikings. Sam Miller, Luke Burgett in the corner. Won't go, but Nungester comes away with the offensive rebound.
Well, maybe the first bad shot we've seen from beyond the arc tonight for the Vikings.
And an errant pass from Cole Nungester. That'll be another turnover for the Vikings with 2:14 now left in the game.
The lead still sits at 11. So once again, the Falcons are going to have to create some shot opportunities here.
Inside the Smelter. Miller tried to draw a charge, couldn't get it to go, and Smelter with a strong take on his offensive rebound. And he will draw a foul that time with just under 2 minutes left in the game.
And I'm surprised Miller did not get that charge from the official there. He was outside of the restricted area, planted his feet, but apparently the official did not see enough to call a charge. And now the Falcons are going to go to the line.
Melcher knocks down his first. Stansberry will check back in for Fairfield Union. 1:57 now left in the game. A 10-point game. Smelter could cut it to single digits here with this free throw. And he does just that. And we'll have a timeout now. We'll take a quick break for a word from our sponsors.
Business. Banking with the Savings Bank is now smarter and faster than ever. Introducing the Smart Business Suite of banking products designed to help you spend more time on business and less time on banking. These include MyTSB Mobile for Business, Remote Deposit Capture, and Online Bill Pay. Begin your journey towards smarter business banking by stopping by any of our branches today. The Savings Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Welcome back, Viking Nation. 1:57 now left in the game. Caleb Smelter cut the Vikings lead to 9 with 2 free throws just before the timeout. Vikings will have the ball. Falcons with 3 team fouls here in the quarter. Teays Valley with 2. And Fairfield Union will look to pick up full court here now as Luke Berger will take it out underneath for the Vikings.
Well, for the majority of this quarter, Teays Valley has had a double-digit lead over Fairfield Union. So now the Falcons are making it close. We're going to see how the Vikings respond here.
And a quick foul on Smelter. That'll be his second. That'll be the 4th team foul on the Falcons. And again, as we mentioned earlier, if you haven't watched much high school basketball this year, there's a new rule change. So the 5th foul of every quarter puts the opposing team in the double bonus. 2 automatic free throws.
And worth noting, Caleb Redding still in the game, has played most of this 4th quarter with 4 fouls. Been able to keep it clean so far, but we're going to see if the Vikings want to target him a little bit here.
That's true. That's a great point. And Stansberry picks up his 4th on that foul. And that'll be the 5th overall for Fairfield Union. It looks like they're going to put the Vikings on the line on purpose.
And it looks like Stansberry is also going to stay in the game along with Redding. So 2 of the Falcons' current 5 players are going to have 4 fouls.
Sam Miller knocks down the first. And he's able to knock down the pair for Teays Valley now. 1:44 left in the game.
Well, five out of the last five free throws made for Sam Miller. You like to see that from your big man.
And strong take that time by Redding. Gets it to go off the glass.
Well, Redding just challenged the defender there. Made the most out of that as Brody Fields draws a foul on the offensive end.
That'll be the third on Rally. And again, we'll put Brody Fields at the line shooting two with 1:18 now left in the game. And Simon, as you alluded to earlier in the game, it will be interesting this year to see how coaches use this new rule and what strategy they employ. And in this game tonight, it looks like Fairfield Union is going to just try to put the Vikings at the line.
Yeah, absolutely. Somewhat of a questionable decision with Brody Fields as the target. Obviously, we know his free throw percentage is through the roof.
Absolutely. So just over a minute to go here now. 59-48, Vikings with the lead. And Kevin McDowell is going to get called for the fouls. He couldn't get his feet set for the charge. And that'll be his fifth. I'll check that. That'll be his fourth. I had him down for his fifth. So.
Well, that's twice this game that we've seen the Vikings try to draw a charge down here under the basket, and it hasn't been awarded.
Smeltzer tries a tough step back three. Kicks it back out, though. Another three for Fairfield Union, and that time it goes. Einkorn with his first bucket of the night. And a Vikings turnover. That makes it 59-51 with just 53 seconds now left in the game.
Well, as we go under a minute here, the Falcons showing some life, threatening Teays Valley's lead, making them a little nervous.
Smeltzer inside. Tough turnaround, and he's able to get it to go.
And now their leader finally stepping up here on the offensive end, getting a shot to go.
Fields gets it across for the Vikings. And a lot of contact, but another turnover. Smeltzer can't get it to go. And Cole Nungester pulls it down for the Vikings, and this time they will call a foul. With 24.4 left in the game.
Good job by Nungester holding strong with the possession of the ball there. Drawing the foul, he's going to send him to the line.
That will be on Stansbury, and that will be his fifth.
So there we saw the decision to keep Stansbury in. He ends up fouling out, albeit with only 24 seconds left in the game.
That'll put Cole Nungester at the line for the Vikings. Nungester gets the roll, so 24.4 left in the game. 61-53, Vikings with the lead. Smeltzer for Fairfield Union. Has to hurry, puts up a tough shot, won't go. Gets his own rebound. Takes it up strong again and gets it to go. And we'll have a quick timeout from Fairfield Union with 7.5 left.
Well, that was a good take by...
Business banking with the Savings Bank is now smarter and faster than ever. Introducing the Smart Business Suite of banking products designed to help you spend more time on business and less time on banking. They include MyTSB Mobile for Business, Remote Deposit Capture, and Online Bill Pay. Begin your journey towards smarter business banking by stopping by any of our branches today. The Savings Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Welcome back, Viking Nation. 7.5 here left in the game. Vikings holding on to a 61-55 lead. They are in the double bonus, and they will have the ball out of bounds. They will have to go the length of the court, and Fairfield Union at this point, picking up full court. They don't have much choice, but they have made it difficult here in the last minute or two of the game.
Yeah, 6-point game, still a two-possession game here. And Fairfield Union's bench and fans are really wanting a technical here on the Vikings for not breaking the huddle soon enough. The referee cutting them a little bit of slack, as it's a big moment in the game here.
So Luke Berger will take it out for the Vikings. He gets it to Cole Nungester. And hard foul that time by Smelter. They didn't call the first attempt, so he made certain they would call the second.
Yeah, he definitely made it known that he was trying to foul him there. Now the Vikings fans unhappy, want a technical on the other end.
So 4.5 left on the clock.
Nungester has a chance to really put this game out of reach for the Falcons here with one or two makes.
Can't get the first one to go.
Now the Vikings get ready to play defense, sending everybody else beyond half court.
He's able to knock down that one, so 18 on the night for Cole Nungester. Kevin McDowell will check in now for the Vikings with 4.5 left on the clock.
And it looks like the Vikings are going to take up a little bit of a press of their own here.
Smelter with a tough three, knocks it down at the buzzer. And that'll make the final 62-58 as the Vikings hold on for a big Mid-State League win tonight. Thanks to our crew tonight, Simon, my sidekick here, and Willie G on the sound and control panel. Till next time, Viking Nation, we'll see you Tuesday night as the Lady Vikings will host Hamilton Township.
Final score, Dana, 1962, and Fairfield Union Falcons 58.
got his fill up there too.
Thank you.
I'm good.